Hi guys, my name is Kuyanche and welcome to episode 9 of my Logistics Pipes tutorial series for Minecraft 1.7.10. So last episode we spoke about how you're able to autocraft using items that don't actually get used up in the recipe, like for example buckets. This episode though we will get talking about basic fluid manipulation using logistics pipes, so let's get started. So like always, I made myself another demonstration world to pretty much show you guys the ins and outs of what I wanted to show you this episode. So pretty much, this subject has been suggested on my latest video, so thank you very much for the suggestion, and I will always love to cover what you guys would like to see me cover most, so here we go. So like always, first of all, we got ourselves a creative energy cell, some redstone energy flux ducts, and a logistic power junction to power this network. Some basic logistics pipe hooking this system up, but then most few things are already quite new. So, first of all, we got the storage side. I pretty much divided this system into two parts. The main part, which will actually supply liquids to other devices, for example tanks, and a system that actually uses the fluids, or at least a place to send them to. So pretty much what I got set up here is 4 different tanks using 4 different fluids. So in this case, lava, water, destabilized redstone and energized glowstone in some fancy open block tanks. So that's pretty cool. Connected to that, I got myself some logistics fluid provider pipes, which are needed to actually provide fluids, as the name would suggest, from the connected inventory to the rest of your network. I did the same to this one. Pretty much to show you guys that you don't have to have one connected to each tank, but simply putting one in the middle like this won't interfere with the tanks at all, so that is pretty cool. Then right here, as you can see, I got myself some logistics fluid basic pipes, pretty much an upgrade to the regular basic pipes, just to make it a little bit easier to both understand where you want to send fluids and where not. But I believe it also handles fluids a little bit better than regular basic pipes, even though I believe both work. So I'm not 100% sure, but yeah, pretty cool. Then, as you can see right here, I got myself some logistics fluid supplier pipes set up. Just like the regular supplier pipes, you can kind of guess what they do. Pretty much the provider pipes provide items or fluids, and the supplier pipes actually supply the items or fluids. So, these things don't have an interface. If I try to right-click them with a wrench, you'll see nothing happens, besides some fancy sparkling, meaning it is connected. But if I try to right-click on the logistics fluid supplier, you would see quite a fancy interface. Yes, pretty cool. Here you can pretty much specify the fluids that you want to keep stocked, as the GUI says. You can either do this by getting a bucket or any container that's holding a liquid and right-click on this slot. So like that, right click to clear it, left click to place it, pretty cool. Or what you can do is simply left click this thing once it is empty, and you will get yourself an interface seeing all the liquids that are currently registered in Minecraft Forge, pretty cool. Do keep in mind the localization, aka the name, is kinda messed up on some things, like Fluid, Binny, Juice, Elderberry, that's I believe from Forestry, as Binny is the mod developer from that. Some fluids have a weird name for that, but you know, all basic fluids have the proper name, like water, lava, all that kind of cool stuff. So, simply specify the liquid that you want to keep supplied in the connected inventory. Then specify the amount of millibuckets you want to keep in that inventory. So, pretty much one bucket is equals 1,000 millibuckets, so keep that in mind. So, every time I add 1,000, it will pretty much know, like, okay, it will send one bucket over. Pretty cool. Then you can send it to a partial yes or no, pretty much meaning that if you're able to supply, for example, 5,000, but you're requesting 10,000 in this fluid supplier, if it's set to partial, it will request. If it has set to not allow partial request, it won't send it over. And of course, there's the minimal mode, which will pretty much set the minimal amount of requests at a time. So either one bucket, two buckets, five buckets, or none at a minimum at all. So the lowest amount will be sent. So yes, this is pretty cool. I set this up for both water, destabilized redstone, and glowstone, just to pretty much show that these will work completely through each other. So that's pretty cool. So let's quickly demonstrate. If I were to, for example, empty this tank, within a couple of seconds, this system should realize, okay, it's sending some love over, and yeah, just as simple as that pretty much. Pretty cool. Same with water. Within a second, it realizes that it needs to keep it stuck. Destabilize redstone. And this will work with pretty much any fluid that you can put in a tank. So that is pretty awesome. And like I said, this will also work pretty well when you use different fluids at the same time. So if I were to quickly go into creative mode, get myself some more buckets, and let's say empty all of these. You will see it starts sending all of the fluids at once through different pipes and will eventually find the proper way to actually send all these liquids. So yes, that is pretty cool. I can find myself quite a lot of different uses in an actual world where you can play in just to keep liquids stored in a specific tank or a machine or pretty much whatever. And that's pretty much it for this video, guys. I definitely hope you guys enjoyed. Be sure to like, comment and subscribe. And I will hope to see you guys all, like always, next time. Take care, folks.